voice of the Lebanese singer Fairuz, more than just a singer, an icon in much of the Arab world. But fans are despondent. They held rallies earlier this week because the 75-year-old has been told by a court to stop performing live. It's all because of a legal case involving a fight with her husband's family over royalties, as I heard from Lebanese journalist Habib Battah.
Fairuz married into one of the most famous playwright and composer families in the Arab world, a real music powerhouse, is the Rahbani family. Her husband and her brother-in-laws were the head of this family and the major playwrights and authors who wrote a lot of her music. One of the brothers has died recently this year, and after the death, there has been this dispute over royalties. The children of one of her brother-in-laws are basically suing for royalties, which they say were not given to them, for music their father composed for her.
And while that is going on, she can't perform any of the music that he was involved in.
Which is a lot of music, a lot of her songs, definitely, and she has hundreds of songs.
And what is then that the impact on the fans? Because she is a much-loved singer, isn't she?
Oh, Fairuz, if there was a top five list of Arab singers of all time, she would be number one for many people. She is a living legend. There is no one alive today of her status. Her music transcends sectarian borders as well. She is a Christian, but her music is loved throughout the Arab world. And although not overtly political, people have taken a big political meaning from her music. And it's been used to announce coup d'etats. And one of her songs has been banned by the president of Syria once. She sings for Palestine. Audiences, when they hear, they cry. There's no admiration really today for an artist like that in the Arab world. And she really electrifies audience. She sells out in her 70s. She's selling out shows throughout the Arab world. She stayed in Beirut throughout all the fighting of the civil war. One of her main songs, O Beirut, was the anthem for hope at a time when the country was torn by militia violence. And even the competing militia TV stations and radio stations would play her song, despite the fierce hatred between them. Her song was a kind of a unifying force at a time when the country was torn through the worst shelling any country's ever seen. She's very much the voice of Lebanon and the voice of hope.
She's an icon, really, as much as she is a singer. It's about her personality and her past as well.
Yes, her music brings this kind of a folkloric remembering the bygone days of the village life. She really taps into people's memories and their deepest emotions of an idyllic life in the Arab world.
Are you surprised, given all of that, that the courts have got involved?
Well, this is a very high-profile case, and as I said, the family that she married into has very much made her career, and she made that family's career as well. So we're talking about two very big players here. The Rahbani family has produced some of the most well-known plays in the Arab world. These are two titans, really. They made each other, in a sense. I'm surprised because music copyright infringement and the laws governing music are not very well respected in the Arab world. Piracy is rampant. I was interviewing once one of her nephews, Fairuz's nephews, who's an artist, and he said that piracy is a cancer in Lebanon, that the government really does nothing about it. So a high-profile case of the government really sticking to royalties is kind of rare.
I was talking to Lebanese journalist Habib Battah about legendary singer Fairuz, banned by a court from live performing. So let's leave you with one of her recordings from all of us at NewsHour. Goodbye.